two rural fire service volunteers have made the ultimate sacrifice, killed late last night while fighting a blaze southwest of Sydney. The men, both fathers to young children, died when their truck rolled.
With flags at half-mast, the New South Wales firefighting community is grieving.
Last night, just before midnight, the worst imaginable set of circumstances unfolded on the Green Wattle fire.
Two volunteers, Andrew O'Dwyer and Jeff Keaton from Western Sydney, were travelling in a convoy on Wilson Drive in Buxton when their fire truck flipped, killing both men.
Two highly respected and much loved firefighters died as a result of that horrific accident, and three people in the back seat of the truck sustained injuries.
Their colleagues administered first aid until help arrived.
It's a tragic blow for their families, for the RFS extended family, and of course for the entire community.
Tributes flowed for the fallen young fathers. The Prime Minister releasing in a statement, they were bravely defending their communities with an unmatched spirit and a dedication that will forever set them apart amongst our most courageous Australians. Friends and strangers left messages of gratitude, while Premier Gladys Berejiklian and RFS Commissioner Shane Fitzsimmons consoled volunteers at Horsley Park, where the men were based. These communities in the path of the Green Wattle fire is what the two young men were trying to protect when they lost their lives. That sacrifice is on the minds of those still battling the blaze.
We're going past over hoses.
This afternoon, reinforcements arrived. Among their ranks, a former Prime Minister.
This is a dreadful tragedy, but these guys were serving the community, and it's just one of those dreadful, dreadful things that happens in a dangerous situation where people are trying to serve.
Very sad. Can't think how a song would be if it was my family, but knowing that they've died for a purpose, and let's hope that they can get it under control so therefore that no one else, you know, gets injured or suffers anymore.
A hope shared by all families ahead of another catastrophic day. Amelia Turzon, ABC News, Bargo.